My name is Ray Ajoya, a follower of Jesus Christ, from when I accepted him in as my Lord and Savior 63 years ago, last March 10th. From that day, Jesus became not just my friend, but has also faithfully walked with me through mountains and valleys and has never left me, not even for a moment. There have been times when I have tried to go my own way, but even then, Jesus talks to me and lovingly draws me back to him. Today is Harvest Thanksgiving Day, and I have so much to thank God for the harvest that he has given me in my life. What I have gotten and experienced along the way since Jesus came into my life is so much that it would take me more than the time we have for this service if I were to tell even half of it. I'm now a wife, having married my dear husband, Timothy Joya, 53 years ago. I'm also a mother of a son and four daughters, and I have four grandchildren. My journey of faith through those years, both before and after I got married, has had its ups and downs, but I testify to the Lord's love and grace through them all. God has done miracles. In 1977, we were attacked by thugs who cut my husband and left him for dead and stabbed me in the knee. But I saw God's care through the ordeal. Before my husband passed out, he told them that he had forgiven them and they should also forgive him, and he further asked God to forgive us all. That seemed to have changed the thugs' mission, and they took some sisal string from our store and tied his head, which they had cut, and my knee that they had stabbed, and that slowed the bleeding. When they picked a Bible that I had on the shelf and said they would take it, I told them, take it and please read it. I guess they didn't want to read, so they put the Bible back and told me that they would leave that for me. When I was sacked from my job, and the reason given was, and I quote, the problem with this woman is that she does not eat and does not let those who want to eat, eat. The Lord gave me a text, Psalm 37, verses 1 to 6, and that brought my anxiety to an end. Later, God proved to me that just like Joseph, who had been sent to Egypt as a slave, but God was preparing him for so he could save the family and the Egyptians from famine, God had sent those people to push me out of that job so God could use me in the Bible ministry where I served for 26 years. That also turned out to be a better paying job, which enabled my husband and I to take care of our family during the time when he lost his job after the church kicked him out because they were unhappy with his preaching. So even when we suffer injustices, God can still use them to make us and to take us where he wants us to be. During difficult times, the Lord keeps urging me to trust and obey him, and doing so gives me peace and joy. In 1987, the day before our daughter was to go back to school, she asked me, and I quote, since we were struggling financially while Dad had a job, now that he doesn't have a job, what will we do? My response to her was, we belong to God and he'll take care of us. That evening, a couple from this church, whom we didn't even know, came to our house and told us that God had told them that the minister's children should be able to go to school when other children are going back. They gave us an envelope, which I gave to my daughter without even opening it. In the envelope was the exact amount of money that our daughter needed so she would be able to go back to school with the other children the next day. Another miracle. We serve a mighty God and can trust him to meet us at our points of need. As farmers share the food they harvest, as followers of Jesus Christ, he has challenged me to share what he has given me, and for the last 16 years, God has enabled me to support at least one girl each year at the Starehe Girls Center, and it is a great joy and thanks to God to see those who have completed go on to university and eventually even enter the job market. When I was still a Sunday school kid, there was a Sunday school teacher, mother of Titus Gatua, whom some of you may remember, who lived just beyond our home. And so she would walk with us as we went to Sunday school on Sunday mornings. She was walking fast, and therefore, for us kids, we had to run to keep up with her. As she walked, she was singing, "I have decided to follow Jesus, no turning back, no turning back." And she would emphasize to us that once you decide to follow Jesus, there is no turning back. That message really sank in me, and therefore, when I got saved, I prayed that God would help me to never turn back. I thank God that at age 77, I have not turned back, and I trust God to carry me through the remaining years until I get my crown and Jesus welcomes me home. So I appeal to adults to be careful what they communicate to kids and those who are younger than them. You never know what will impact their lives. Another thing that God has taught me is to do my best to uplift anyone that God brings across my path, no matter what their background. It gives me a lot of joy to see women who worked in our house as house helps establish their own businesses and become self-supporting through skills that I either taught them or paid for them to learn. Jesus called people like Peter, who had little education, and after being with him, they went on to wonderfully tell others the good news of salvation. So let us do likewise. My challenge to each one of us is to impact anyone that God brings across our path. Pay them well so that they are able to improve their lives. In summary, my harvest thanksgiving is for one, salvation, because it is so sweet to trust in Jesus, and in him I have found peace and joy. Two, life, because as the psalmist said, those who are dead cannot praise God. Three, health, because sickness can not only cause family breakups, but it can also cause economic ruin. Four, family, because family unity and support have enabled me to be who I am. Five, economic stability at this age. And six, and finally, not the least, Christian community, because this gives me company and gives me encouragement along my journey of faith. May God bless you all.